Welcome to the McKinley Café Kitchen here at the University of Michigan-Dearborn. My name is Allen Attee. I'm a co-owner and CEO of Picasso Restaurant Group, the food service provider here at the University of Michigan-Dearborn. Joining me today is Mr. Dak Zorn. He's one of our corporate executive chefs as well as the executive chef here at the Dearborn campus. So we were asked to prepare a holiday appetizer for you folks and do a little demo on that. And so the appetizer we chose is a chicken pea pod sesame wrap. And several reasons for the selection. One, it's cost efficient. Two, during the busy holiday season, it's actually a pretty easy appetizer to throw together. And three, when it's all done, it has festive holiday colors to it. So I'm gonna turn it over to somebody who's much more experienced than me in the kitchen. I'm sous chef level at best. And I'll turn it over to Dak Zorn, and he'll take us most of the way here.
Thank you, Alan. All right, so we're gonna start off with a 5 ounce chicken breast. It's normally what we use here in the kitchen. These breasts cost us about $1.10 a portion. The appetizer itself's really reasonable and fairly price efficient. All right, so I got some pre-cut chicken here. So we got the breast. Normally I cut about 3 strips lengthways. And then really you can stretch this out into about 9 different portions. So about $1.10 a chicken breast, 9 portions, you know, cost about 12 cents a piece, which is not bad when it's around the holiday time. All right, so we got the chicken here. I'm gonna put it in that bowl. We just cut them up in those cubes. Got my trash can down here. Change my gloves over.
It's always important when working with chicken to change gloves, sanitize surfaces, things of that nature.
Yeah, we're not trying to cross-contaminate or get anybody sick, especially around the holiday time. It does seem to happen.
How about the in-laws?
No? Well, from time to time, that's maybe appropriate.
Pro tip.
That's what family you're in. All right, so we got the batter here. We got half flour, half breadcrumbs. Got this bowl here. Just as easy as putting the breadcrumbs in the bowl. Half breadcrumbs, which is these are actually Japanese breadcrumbs, which is also called panko. And we got some flour. We're gonna do white sesame seeds, and we're also gonna do some black. So it's just kind of good having both different colors in there. We normally it's visually before we start tasting it. So we're gonna mix that up. Also, a key ingredient is a little ginger powder. And just a little salt and pepper. A little bit of salt and pepper goes a long way. All right, so we got that there. We're gonna take our chicken breast.
You're gonna marinate that chicken breast now?
Marinating chicken breast is also really important. I'm glad you caught me on that one.
My
boss is, boss comes through from time to time. All right, so on the chicken, it's really in a perfect world. It's nice to marinate 12 hours in advance. You can definitely do it overnight. Really, the longer you do it, the more the flavors are gonna infuse into the chicken and the better it will be. So I got a little bit of sesame oil. And we got sweet chili sauce, which you can get, you know, just at a regular grocery store. So all these ingredients are definitely available. And then we have soy sauce. So soy sauce, sesame oil, and sweet chili sauce. So this we're just doing right away, but like I said, it's nice to get a couple hours in there. Overnight's even better.
And Dak, do we have to add salt and pepper to that, or does the soy sauce, the salt from that, kind of take care of that where you don't have to add the salt?
Yeah, so really you wouldn't have to add salt and pepper because the soy definitely has enough of it. You know, it's quite a bit of sodium in there. We also have salt and pepper in the breadcrumbs. So, all right, so we got the breadcrumbs right here. I'm just gonna take a couple of these out, show you how it's done. And we'll drop them in this pot over here. I'll discuss that here in a minute. All right, just kind of toss those around. Make sure it sticks to it. All right, so if you're doing bigger batches, of course you could use a colander, shake them around. We're just doing a real small batch here. So I'm just gonna put them in my hand. So I got a pot of oil behind me. You always wanna get that to about 350 degrees to 375. That's already behind me and going, so I'm gonna turn around and drop these in the oil. All right, so we can let those fry up, get golden brown. Put these to the side. Now we got the the snow peas. All right, so the snow peas, all we're gonna do here is just blanch them. Blanch them, more or less this means pop them in hot water. We're gonna soften them up a little bit. I got some boiling water here, also with a little bit of salt in it. This goes real fast. It's really only about probably about 40 seconds. So we've made, what, probably thousands of these, huh?
Thousands. Our most popular appetizer.
Thousands and thousands, but it's definitely one of the favorites. All right, so while we're waiting on that,
you know, important note too, when you're cutting the chicken or dicing it like Dak did, try to get the cuts as even as possible so your cook time is kind of the same for all of those pieces of chicken. You don't want real big chunks and then real small chunks. The more even, the better on that. And you want to take chicken to, what is it, 165?
Yeah, so the chicken needs to be cooked to 165. A lot of times when it comes out of the fryer, it's golden brown, but we still put it in the oven for another 2 to 3 minutes just to make sure it cooks. So these pea pod wraps, so we're just cooking them off and now we're gonna blanch them, which just more or less means coming from hot water into cold water. And the purpose of that is, it's just gonna stop the cooking time. So we're just gonna stop the cooking time real fast on these. It only takes, you know, about less than a minute on that, so real fast.
And if you don't do that, they'll turn a much darker green color and they don't look nearly as appetizing. So a super important step. Really with a lot of vegetables that
really
you cook,
is
to hit them that way.
It also kind of turns, you know, a grayer color and it doesn't maintain the bright green color. All right, also important when these come out, which they cool down real fast, you know, it's a real thin, delicate vegetable. We're just gonna put them on a little bit of a paper towel. Now, of course, if you're doing more, because your family's larger or bigger, we just use more towel.
That's a great pro tip there, Deck.
It is.
Bigger towel, bigger family.
Bigger family. Yeah, I'm trying to keep a smaller family, but. All right, so we got
now
these.
We
got
to get our chicken out of there.
So how's that looking back there?
Oh, that is looking done.
Done?
Yeah, where's those tongs? Is that oil is
oh,
hot.
Oh, yeah. All right, so be careful with this oil.
And normally, what do those take about that size? About 6-7 minutes without the magic of TV?
It takes about 5 or 6 minutes, yep. And then, like I said, we normally pop these back in the oven to make sure that they are cooked. Now, of course, you can always eat one, crack into one to make sure it's cooked or not, which I highly recommend. Like we talked about before, you don't want to get anybody sick. All right, so we got these little bamboo 4-inch skewers. You can use a toothpick, bamboo sticks, whatever you might have lying around the house. These bamboo sticks we kind of like because they got, you know, a nice little look to them. All right.
I'm going to do one because I feel a little useless in this
All right, hop on in there.
So you wrap the pea pod around this way, around the chicken. Stick it right through that guy.
And then we do have a platter here that we already were working on.
But right up on top.
Let's put it right there. So we already got some going there. This is a sweet chili sauce. This just came over the counter. We didn't jazz it up. Of course you could if you want. It is really good just right off the counter. So the sweet chili sauce, we got a couple of garnishes here. Allen made these really nice scallion bushes, which look, you know, fabulous. And once again, so you make pea pod wraps, just kind of put them on the platter, make it look nice, and voila, that's the sesame chicken pea pod wrap.
Bam. Thanks for joining us today.